Although it's springtime, winter's coming. Remember the fairy tale ant and the grasshopper? Well, which are you? Are you prepared financially for what's coming? It's time we have a real conversation about money. Sustainability movement, where I show you alternative financial building methodologies that enable you to live off your savings and investments. Be sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell below to get notified when new videos are added. Shout out to the TVT gang and Sister Knight for allowing the Cryptowoke Financial Sustainability Movement to be on her platform. She's doing amazing work, and please be sure to subscribe and stay abreast of what she's got going on. Remember the fairy tale, the ant and the grasshopper? Well, in this case, winter is this recession that we're feeling right now. Let me ask you these three very personal questions. What would you do if you showed up on a Monday to your job and you found out that you were being let go? What would be the first thing you think about? In most cases, you would be thinking about your money source. Where am I gonna get my money from now? This is what sustains me and my family. The second question, do you live paycheck to paycheck? And if so, what is your plan to earn more? And there's a part B to this. If not, do you have more than 6 months savings? And the third question is, have you ever said, I really can't complain, at least I have a job? And what I mean by that is we'll talk about how much we hate our job, we work all these hours, we get underpaid, but in the end we'll say, well, I really can't complain, at least I have a job. And if this is you, you need to go back to question number one. Again, what would you do if you showed up on a Monday morning or a Friday before 5 o'clock and you found that you were being let go? So this is the endless cycle that we all will go through at some point in time of in our working careers. And the question is, what are you doing to break this cycle? It comes down to this basic quote. If you don't design your own plan, chances are you'll fall into someone else's plans. And guess what they have planned for you? Not much. So I ask you, which are you? Are you that ant that is spending its summer putting away food and resources for that winter that we know is evidently coming and where you'll be unable to go out and get these resources? Or are you the grasshopper that's sitting there in the summertime enjoying the weather and the sun and just enjoying life and not really thinking about tomorrow, you're just living in the moment? And these are very real questions that I think we should think about, because they have this old fable of saying, you know, give a man a fish and feed him a day, teach a man a fish and you'll feed him for a lifetime. Well, there's a switch to that, I think. We should update. Like, give a man a fish and feed him for a day, but don't teach a man to fish and feed yourself. He's a grown man, and guess what? Fishing ain't that hard anyway. So if you allow someone to feed you, you also allow them to starve you. Pre-COVID-19, we saw the job market was demeaningly increasing. With all the jobs that were created, the question is, what type of jobs were they? I mean, we're facing raising costs, we're facing gentrification, and as well, the job qualities are low. Most of these jobs that are being created are part-time, and they don't even give you benefits. We also gotta look at the fact that there have been major Fortune 500 companies that have been going under. They have been laying off people in the thousands. Ford last summer laid off 8,000 workers. HP in October of last year let go 9,000 people. We know something's not right, but don't know how to address it. And the way I see it is that we're fueling our own gentrification through corporate Stockholm syndrome. And what I mean by that is, you might be in a position at your job where you know you're not being paid what you're worth, you're being underpaid, you're being overworked, but you're afraid to say something because if you do, it could mean you losing your job. Post-COVID-19, we've seen that the job market is literally crashing. For the month of April, we saw that nearly 20.5 million Americans lost their jobs in that month. The highest ever recorded. So let's think about this. The job market really doesn't offer the tenure we're used to, pandemic or not. If you really think about it, we're supposed to work to the age of 65, right? And life expectancy is at 78. So you're telling me we're supposed to work 50 years just to be free for 13? So let's realize that the job market, again, doesn't offer that tenure we're used to having. And this is the bottom line. No employer is obligated to pay you for the rest of your life. One day, each and every one of us will experience this. We'll either be laid off or we'll be fired. And if we're lucky, we'll make it to retirement. But at that point, That is when the relationship with you and your employer ends, whereas you will no longer receive a paycheck. The thing is that consistently every 30 days you do have a bill that's due. So what is now going to be your new source of income if you're no longer being employed? And because of that, the older you get, the closer you are to losing that job. So in these twilight years that we look for, we put money away into savings and retirements and IRAs and 401ks in these volatile market systems that we think are going to be there when we need it. Once we do get in that situation, if there's a pandemic or there's a recession and we see that these retirements savings are being tapped and we're losing large percentages of it, if we're too old to get a job, how are we going to be able to pay our bills? This is the thing that we need to think about, is how are we going to sustain ourselves? And we must face the very real fact that if you die today, your job will be posted online before your obituary. And when we think about artificial intelligence, we see these things that are happening right before our eyes. You know, self-driving cars are going to become a reality within the next 2 to 5 years. We're seeing it in the trucking industry. 40% of the malls are going to be shut down within the next 2 years, because as I'm guilty of, is shopping online more than going to the actual store. And when you do that, you eliminate humans from doing the actual jobs because no one's showing up to the malls. You know, we've seen 2.5 million call centers that will be replaced. And we all have that conversation where you're talking to, some sort of robot opposed to talking to a person. Mainly we're seeing these replacements in retails and sales, food and service, food prep, shipping, administrative and clerical, but it will also reach up into the white collar job sector. So the reach of AI is going to affect millions, if not hundreds of millions of workers that will now be replaced without a job. How will they be able to pay for their income is the question. And we've seen these things. If you've been driving into, like, for instance, you drive to New York City and you go to the Holland Tunnel, you'll see the Easy Pass, you know, where you can actually just drive through and not have to talk to someone or hand them any money and get a receipt. That's replacing a worker. You might have been to Walmart or you've been to Home Depot where you have that speed checkout where basically you go in and you check your food out or your goods out yourself, opposed to a bagger or cashier being there for you. The onus is on you to do the work now. Well, that's being automated. That means that eliminated another person that used to be doing that job. You go into banks today and you make a deposit. No longer are you seeing the tellers. You're going into big machine kiosks where you can put your money in there and not even speaking to someone. That, again, is replacing a job of a human. So we're starting to see AI is taking over. And because of that, you know, we're going to be in a position where we're going to have to find another way to earn money. And if there's less jobs that we can actually do to get paid for, what are we going to do? What else can we do? So there's the saying, where your attention goes, your time goes. So what I want to do is switch it. And instead of worrying about all of the chaos that we're facing, if it's not the pandemic or it's the loss of jobs or the loss of wages, is what can we do to switch that up and be on the positive end? So I'm going to change my attention and put my time towards something else, and I want to share that with you. So our learning systems are designed to purposely keep this from us. And if you really think about it, no one's ever going to give you the education you need to overthrow them. So there needs to be some onus on us. We need to do our own diligence and understand that we've been taught the traditional way of going to school and getting the BA and masters and PhDs and coming out in debt, more in debt than we were when we went in. And then to find out there's a job labor workforce or pipeline that is being decimated by artificial intelligence, that we need to do something different. So again, I come to that question, you know, which are you? Are you that ant or are you that grasshopper? Are you preparing for winter or are you just gonna sit there and let things just happen? And in one way to become more of the ant, if you want to be, is adopting what a lot of rich folk use, which is simple. It's a 5-hour rule. And it basically means if you're not spending 5 hours a week learning something, then you're being irresponsible. So in these videos, we're going to talk about the 5-hour rule and how we can implement some of those strategies into making better financial decisions to put us on the path towards financial sustainability and also creating intergenerational wealth. So I hope you'll stay tuned in. If you like what you heard today, visit CryptoWokeMovement.com. CryptoWokeMovement.com. And you might ask, well, what is CryptoWoke? Well, CryptoWoke, basically, if you think about it, the word crypto is in it, and don't run with the fact that, oh, he's talking about cryptocurrency. No, I'm not talking about cryptocurrency. The etymology of the word crypto is hidden. So what I'm talking about through the Cryptowoke Financial Sustainability Movement is cryptic or hidden money method ways that rich families have used over the last 200 years that have been recession-proof in creating intergenerational wealth. So the goal is to get 300 people financially literate and on the path towards sustainability. And phase two is to move those 300 towards physical and virtual cooperative communities, creating intergenerational economic, ecological, and cultural resuscitation and preservation by way of joint endeavors. What does that mean? That basically means that if I can get my money situation right, you have your money situation right, and we're financially sustainable as individuals and families, then those families can come together. And instead of buying a house, we can buy a block. Instead of creating a small business, we can create an enterprise. You know, these are the situations that we can put ourselves into to create intergenerational wealth. And so we won't be susceptible to job loss, recessions, and things of those natures. So that's what this is really all about. There'll be more videos coming up. Please stay tuned, talking about topics of financial literacy. And be again sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell to get notified when new videos are added. And as well, be sure to watch the other videos. So until then, I'll see you next time. Join the movement, the Cryptowoke Financial Sustainability Movement, where you can live the life of your choosing off your savings and investments. Bless.